I'm regretting my choice of sweater. Even though it is gloomy, it's raining, it's gray, I'm so hot. I blame it on my pregnancy, I do. But oh my god, it is warm up here. I'm still very pumped about me having a baby in like 1.5 months. And if you're curious, you want to see my baby? Look at her. She is so big right now. 2 kilos. 2.5-ish. So, I'm excited. I was inspired by Chick-Geek. I was just watching her, a bunch of her videos, and she had this bright yellow gold in her corner, and I was like, I want to have that as well. And baby girl is here, if you hear these noises. Okay. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to do a bunch of Project Pan updates and finales and everything all in one video. I did a poll here on my YouTube community tab something, and it was almost 50-50 if you wanted separate videos or one big one, but one big video had the most votes, so that is what I'm going to do, and frankly that is what I feel I can manage at this point. So let's go on to the finales, and I will start out with the whole collection Project Pan that I started in the beginning of the year with Emily, and a lot of ladies and I joined her and Sarah for the collab this year, and I have been really enjoying it, and I have some footage for this September update that I will insert as well when I talk about the products. The first product that is on my list is my Benefit Rocket Tour blush. It is still at this state where I have scraped some out, and that also means I still have the Franken blush that I did where I mixed Curlista and the Rocket Tour blush. It is getting down there and it's getting low, and it is the mixture I have on my cheeks today, and it is the mixture I have been using when I've worn makeup since I repressed it in that video in like July or something. It takes a little while, but I'm getting there. And I enjoy the mixture because it is this corally pinky peach shade, which matches a lot of my looks that I do. So that is the final touch at that one. I will finish it up sooner or later, just not now. The next product is an empty, and that is my W7 Brow Sweep Grooming Crayon. It is this guy right here that you might have seen. So here it is, completely gone. Well, I could dig out, but I don't want to. But yes, it now scratches my eyebrows and just takes off hair when it doesn't need to. So that is done. The next one is my MAC Brave lipstick, and I haven't used this since I stopped at work when I went on maternity leave. No, I haven't used it since. So it's kind of small, but yeah, it's getting down there. I don't think there's any progress. Let me just show you. Well, again, since September. No. Like, okay, there will be like a millimeter of progress. But I'm pretty sure that is either my August update or September update deadline. I will insert the progress from last time. Then we have this lip gloss, the W7 Metal Kiss in Ace Face? Ace Face. I haven't used it at all. I've used it total in 3 times in this project overall, and since I rebooted it in like June, I just don't feel like this metallic lip gloss. I just don't feel like it. So that has not been used at all since like July. Then we have this red liquid lipstick from W7 as well. It is the Velvet Secret, And this is called Vino Tino. And I have used this 2 times. And that has been in this past week, actually. Which is really, really great. I want a red lip 3 times this week. And this week only. Who am I? I don't know. I just felt like full glam because I haven't worn makeup in like 2 months. But yes, so in total I have used this 4 times. It's not great, but it's progress, you know? Then we have my liquid liner, this Love Line from W7. I have outdone my tally for this. My tallies overall for these products where I have counted the uses. The usage goal was 20 times. For this one, I have used it 22 times. So I have outdone myself and I have just been loving wearing it like a small wing or a big wing. But yes, I will forever use that one until it's done. Then we have this one. And this is my W7 Delicious palette. And I'm working on this red shade right here. And I have used this 15 times, including today. It's not great, but you can see it has a dip. So 15 times is kind of okay, if you think about it. I've been panning a lot of pink, not this one. But when I rolled it in, I was kind of sick of the pink. So that was really unfortunate. But I have a good dip in it now, and I do think I can hit pan on it soon. But yeah, again, not in this project. I'm just going to end it now, even though I have 1 more month. I just don't feel like it. I just don't. Another eyeshadow comes from my Morphe palette, and this is the 35K palette. And I am working on... I was working on this coppery shade right there. It was kind of dark, so it was really hard to use during the summertime. But I did manage to use it 12 times, and 6 of those uses were in the past few months, so that was really, really great. I was really focusing on it in September after the last update that I filmed. If I had worn makeup the past 2 months, I think I would have met my goal, and this palette is better here in the winter time because it's not really summery, it's kind of dark and neutral. And cool tones, so yeah, I will get more use out of it. I will. Another product where I have outdone myself, actually this one and the next one, it is my Sleek Makeup highlighting palette. This one right here, I was working on the peachy shade right there. I don't think you can see, there's no dip. Well, there's a little one, but I don't think you can see it on camera. And I have used that 22 times, and that is including today. I love that highlighting palette so much, and I've been using it on my cheeks, nose, cupid's bow, and if I have worn another highlighter, I've always used this in my inner corners, so I have really been trying my hardest on that one. So that is also a goal met, which is nice. The last shade, the last product that I have hit my goal on, that I also hit my goal on last time when I filmed the update in September, it is an eyebrow powder or an eyeshadow that I use as a brow powder. I have it on today. It is from W7 In The City palette. I have used this like 25 times. I apparently stopped counting it when I hit 20, but at least I have used it 25 times for sure. So that is pretty nice, and I think the progress is really, really great. So this will be easy to use up. Let's do the Graveyard Project Pan finale that I also filmed in September for that update, and then it ended on Halloween. So that has been a month since that ended, but I didn't really hit any of my goals. I didn't, maybe 1 or 2, but let's just go through the products. This was created by Emily, and we did it last year as well as this year And we had two categories, collecting cobwebs and resurrection product. Resurrection. And I chose three products for each category. And for the collecting cobwebs category, I have one empty and some really nice progress on the other two. So the empty is my NYX Lingerie Eye Tint in Whimsy. It was this cream shadow or liquid shadow in this pinky shade. That is exciting. Which means I only have one cream eyeshadow left in my collection. I'm really excited about that actually. The next one is my Max Factor Color Elixir Giant Pen Stick. This one right here. I really, really love this. I wore it yesterday and I reapplied like 2 times. I did good this month, this time. That line got messed up. So not sorry. So as you can see, there is quite a bit of progress, and that is just for using it yesterday. So they go fast, but red is something I really need to focus on and use up because I have a lot. Okay, and the last product in the collecting cobwebs category is my NYX Lingerie liquid lipstick. This one right here. And this shade is Ruffle Trim. So as you can see, there is a window right here. I'm so excited because that means I am all the way down to here on it. And I have used this so much, and all the times that I have worn makeup for the last few months, it has been this lipstick, and I have used up half a liquid lipstick, and that is pretty exciting for me because that is a category that scares me so much to pan. So let's move on to the resurrection products. I can see here in my notes I had the highlighting shade in my NYX Highlight and Contour Pro palette, and I used that up. Don't know if I used it up in September. I think I did. The last product comes from my NYX Highlight and Contour Pro palette. And if you can't see a theme, there's a lot of NYX products in this project, obviously, or apparently. I had the banana shade in this project, and as you can see, it is empty. I haven't finished it because I was going to repress the powder that I was mixing it with for my concealer under eyes setting. Yeah, I used it as an under eye setting powder. So I repressed it, you can see the picture here, with this powder, the selfie powder from Devil 7. So right now it is looking like this. It is a mixture of that bluish powder and the banana shade. So let's just talk about this fail of a product. It is my MAC Witch eyeshadow single, and there's no progress. There's little to no progress. I haven't used it since I filmed in September, so there won't be any progress to show. And then we have the last product, which is this lip gloss pen again. It's one of the Max Factor Giant Pen Sticks. And this is way smaller, as you can see, because I have more progress on that one. I haven't used it since the beginning of September, so that is the progress line from last time. But yes. So that is the update or finale for Graveyard Project Pan. So let's see if we can do more. That took like 5 minutes. Oh my god. Hopefully I have all the products here for my 20 in 20 project plan, because that is also a project that I want to end. So let's just see if we can do this without getting confused. So for the lip primer, I haven't used it since last time, I think. I still have this much product, so I might just declutter that one because I don't like it anymore. So yeah, goodbye in my empty spin. I don't want to work on it anymore, and I don't want to force myself anymore. I'm just done. Then we have this navy eyeliner. It is my P2 Impressive Gel Cajal eyeliner in this navy blue color, and that is called Dramatic Blue. And I actually have used this quite a bit. So let's see if we have any progress. Oh my god, that is so little. That is so disappointing. Right there at that line is where I am right now. That is so disappointing because I have used it quite a bit. This darn thing. I'm just about here in the middle still. I don't think there's much progress on this. I haven't made a new batch of this and I don't know if I want to. I'm so sick of having shimmery lotion and I'm so sick of using this. So, bye bye. So let's just talk about the lotion that I put it in. I still have this much to go and that will be done when in my next shower if baby girl doesn't wake up. She woke up when I took my last shower, so I didn't get to put lotion on. And I only use it on my legs so it doesn't get onto her body. So my next two are my bronzers and the first one is my NYX blush in taupe that I use as a contour. It's this cool toned brown color. And I don't think you can see any progress on this. I haven't really used it. And the next one is my Franken bronzer. I finished up the small bit of Franken bronzer that I had last time, I think. And this is where I am with this one. I don't know if I can finish it by the end of the year, but I will definitely try to do so because I really want to finish off Hoola and some other things that is in here. That would be so nice. But yes, this is where I am with this bronzer and yeah. I swear to you, after having a baby and is breastfeeding, my lips are so dry, but for some reason I don't take my time to use this anymore. I have used quite a bit of it and it is getting there. At least you can see the bottom here. For some reason I'm not using it even though I really should because my lips are so dry. Oh, I forgot my mud mask from the Body Shop. I will insert a picture of where I am with it because I don't want to go get it and I really want to have this video done because I think she is almost waking up. I will insert a picture of it. I have used it once or twice since she came into the world, so I'm not taking the time for myself to use it, but I'm really trying. It is getting down there and it will expire by the end of the year or in January or February, I think it will expire. So I have a few months left of that one to go before it doesn't work anymore. Then we have this heat protection spray. Yeah, it's still at that point. I haven't really used it. Nothing more to say about that one. My serum from the Body Shop. That is definitely down there because I can't use the dropper anymore. Can you even see? I don't think you can. Last time I updated you guys, I was up to here and now I'm like down to here. So I need to pour it out on my hair next time because I can't reach it with the dropper anymore. So that is really exciting to almost have that skincare empty. And my perfume, I haven't really worn that much perfume after she came into the world, maybe a few times. So there's a little bit of progress. So you can see it is getting down there. It's really hard to measure. But yes, this is the One Direction Our Moment perfume. It has this crowny top. It has this top as a crown. And I think it was really, really cute. And yeah, this is almost done. Let's just... Please work. Please work. I tried to film this clip like 10 times. My SD card is just not cooperating. These two images I have tried to talk about 5 times now. I have the cleansing mousse from Ivy Aya that I have finished, like a travel size, and the full size of the Body Shop British Rose shower gel. I really like these, but I'm so glad they are done. I finished up the Body Shop body scrub in the coconut scent, and this is a small size, 48.5 grams. So, small size, but it was really nice. Then we have a few makeup products just to talk about. And the first is an empty actually, and that is the W7 Eye Dream Shadow Cream in Gilded Cage. this one right here. It was like a light gold one, but that is dry and empty. This is almost done. I have just removed the stopper today. It is W7 Safe by the Gel concealer, so this is going to be done by the end of the year for sure, like in the next few weeks, I think. And then we have the Strobe Struck Cream Highlighter from W7. It is so worn because I have used it all year. And I wear this every single time underneath my foundation, on my cheekbones and my nose and everything, underneath my foundation. And it is going. I don't know how the progress is from last time, but we are here. Not great, I think. The W7 Touch and Go Blemish Stick Concealer thing that I use as a highlighting pencil. It is going and it is breaking apart. It's not my favorite, but I haven't really used it. When I started wearing makeup again, I kind of forgot it, so that is good to have this finale video to remind me. I have the Kiss and Gel lip liner in pink. I have it on today only, from W7 as well. I don't think there's a lot of progress on this one, but let's see anyway. Oh, I haven't updated you guys on this lip liner at all since the intro. So that is where I started when I last when I introduced it a few months ago, and that is only for a few uses. I need to sharpen it again because it scratches my lips. This is most likely going to be a very long video, so I hope you had a snack and something to drink, because I'm sorry. I was apparently chatty and very excited to be back, and hopefully you enjoyed as well and are excited to see me again. I missed you guys a lot, and thank you so much for all the love on my last video where you were meeting baby girl for the first time. Again, she is 2 months already, like next week, so yeah. I hope you guys enjoyed, and until my next video, please take care, and I will see you guys again very soon.